I remember. I can even remember the day. That day.
That CD and Game Guides released Master Builders Season 1, this time 1701 AD. Hey guys, it's Matt from CD and Game Guides to introduce the second video in the 1701 AD series. I'm here with Joe this time from WoW Leveling Guides. Joe?
Why'd you bring that up? They're done. That doesn't even make sense anymore.
You failed at completing your guides, and yet I am doing well.
I did not fail. I ran out of time. I got bored. That's not failing. And I'm doing WoW Dungeon Guide. I'm the one who filmed this and edited this. This does not make sense. You're doing well.
Okay, alright.
Doing well. Use proper terms.
Anyway, as you can see, our civilization's coming along well. And our grid system of houses, which we'll go into later, is coming along. And as you can see here, we have the green, yellow, and orange system. These are the happiness levels of the people. And they are reflected on the taxes as well as the resources that are being given to them. So, for example, if you're not getting any resources, there will be no green level. So no matter what your taxes are, you will never make them happy.
You sound like you're talking about how high you are by saying green level. I just thought I'd point that out.
Anyway, moving along here. We have, in that yellow level, as shown before, I didn't explain this in the last one. The people will stay there. If they move out, they won't come back. And Joe just filled the volume a little bit. I don't know if that got picked up, but anyway.
Thor, I forgot to shut off the speakers. Okay, I'm sorry about that.
There's a big blue light, which is...
There's no blue light there anymore. That does not help my eyes.
Just
because it's... Keep talking about the guy.
Anyway.
You're distracting
me. Yellow light, the yellow bar for the people, or whatever the fuck it is.
What happens if little children watch this? They're not gonna like.
I don't care if little children watch this. Little children, this is not rated E. Piss off. Moving right along.
So I guess it's rated P as piss off.
Anyway, the yellow, as I was saying repeatedly, is a neutral level of the people. In other words, if they move out, they will not come back. Population level will not grow, and typically will not decline. And you get a half decent amount of taxes from it if you're producing a good amount of resources. Now, as you can see here, we have our grid system of houses. You see the big field beside the town center where we can put our government-based buildings.
It's more of a forest, and there's trees there. It's not open land, so it's
I realize that, Joe, but everything's a forest until you tear it down. Regardless of which, you see the church.
Not
there.
Everything. The water's not a forest until you tear it down, because you can't tear down water. Or rocks. There's mountains, and they don't have...
land mass, good sir, is... Never mind. It's forested. And until you tear it down and put a house there, it's not a city.
You don't tear it down, you cut it down. You don't tear
cut
a tree
it down,
down.
Whatever.
You demolish anyway, trees, maybe, but you don't tear
as
them
you
down.
As you can see here, we our production facilities are kept separate from the housing. That means that your housing is off to the side, or even on a completely different island, depending on where you're... depending on how your island's designed, if you have enough room for both, you can keep production facilities and residential at the same place. And as more people come, you need more production facilities, so that means more sheep farms, more weaver's huts, etc., according to the people. And in a moment here, we're going to show you some upgrading. As you can see here in the bottom right, actually, this is where we
pretty
banned...
sure that's more the middle section, bottom right, with the smiley guy's face.
Okay, anyway...
That's what he's talking about, he's not sure.
The bottom right of the little menu that popped up in the middle of the screen, just for Joe's... like, bad bearings or whatever.
That's not bad bearings. It's your bad bearings by saying the right. You're going to look at that corner there, and you're going to be confused. It's not my
fault.
Okay,
fine. It's not the skeleton. It's a little hammer with the X. Anyway, it's a little hammer with the X, and that shows that the people are not able to take their resources by themselves and upgrade. As you can see here, the guy with the little top hat thing, the black hat, he's the next social class he just upgraded, and in a moment here, we're going to show you... He's a settler. He's the next social class.
And it's not a top hat. It's more of like a... sombrero, if you want to call it anything.
Not a sombrero, they're not Mexican.
Yeah, but his hat is more shaped like a sombrero. A top hat is just like really low, really small brim, and then top part of the hat's big. Okay, good.
I'm not going to Google the definition of...
We made a clay pit to create bricks, because you need bricks to build stuff.
Yes, that is a clay pit, and that is part of our production facilities, and that was unlocked by the settlers. Now, the settlers... you can tell when the houses need to be upgraded to settlers and other social classes as you level up via a... big arrow that will appear above the house pointing up. And, yes, Joe, the up motion. And you can click on the house and simply press on the upgrade button, which is, see that circle on the right, bottom right corner? There will be a little green light flashing. And you can click on that. And that should be displayed actually in a moment here because more and more resources are being showed up. And if you didn't see before, our town center has a glowing gold guy standing there above the fountain, and that represents that the people are very happy, the civilization's prospering, etc. His expression and color changes accordingly. A regular everyday stone statue means that you're producing just enough, and the people are happy, but they're not ecstatic. And then as you move along,
we made a treaty agreement with a native person. I'm not racist. See, I didn't say heckin' it there.
You really shouldn't, but that's inappropriate. But irregardless of which, ignore Joe's inappropriateness. And we can see here...
It's more racist than inappropriateness. Inappropriateness is saying, like, my tits on fire.
They're both inappropriate.
Taxes are an important part, because taxes make you money.
Yes, Joe, we explained this in the last video.
I wasn't paying attention, because I was too busy playing Nazi zombies. I was killing people.
Yes, you were in the same room. Tatanka, by the way, which was the native guy that popped up, the Iroquois guy, part of one of those random civilizations I told you about before, the little side civilizations. He can provide you with some unique goods, such as furs, which is what you will need for aristocrats, which is the last social class of your people. It will take a while to get there, and they are very, very cranky and very annoying, and they burn down their own houses if, say, for example, you don't have chocolates. But anyway, right here we have an example of a plantation. This plantation is a hops plantation. The only reason why we can place
racist.
This a hops plantation...
Racist. Plantations are racist.
Anyway, okay, plantations...
Think about the Southland plantations.
Yeah,
It's racist.
Yes, okay, but never mind. The plantation here, the hops plantation, can be placed here and it will prosper because, as you can see at the top, middle right at the top of the screen, we have the little hops fertilization, meaning that our island has good soil, then it will be fertile and produce some good hops crops.
Just like
and,
babies.
Yeah, anyway.
You gotta be fertile to produce babies.
Yes, you do, but this isn't health class. And apparently it needs to be let's not be racist class, thanks to Joe over here.
I wasn't trying to be racist. We are not racist at all.
I'm not, but anyway.
I'm not. I swear.
Here, but I don't want to hear. Anyway.
I have friends.
Right here, for example, we have the plantation, and these plantations allow us to make beer from hops. And back there a minute ago, we saw the free trader. As mentioned before, he can buy tools and stuff from him. And the free trader right there offered us a mission to go find, in this case, there are various missions, to find some floating cargo that which when you talk to him will be shown on the map.
Because he loses a lot of stuff.
Yes.
He loses people too. I don't know how
he does
that.
People and he wants you to steal things and that can piss off certain civilizations, etc.
Stealing is bad, kids. Do not do it.
Yes.
Same with murdering. Do not murder. Or rape. Rape is even bad. Worse.
Anyway, so there's a safe screen game. Anyway, so anyway, we get to choose from rewards for fulfilling the mission. In this case, we have to go and pick up the cargo, which is just self-explanatory. Just literally right-click on it when you have your ship selected.
That's the mouse button on the right side of your thing.
Yes, Joe. That is the right side of your thing, which is the mouse. Anyway, so you pick up that cargo and you just send them back to the free trader's island, which is in the middle as always. It's a very small island. Send them back there to the dock, and your free trader will ask if you want to fulfill the mission. You press the little check mark, and it will appear in the top right corner, and you get to choose one of the two prizes. So in our case, we had food and we had gold, and for the second reward, we had gold and golden tools, I believe.
It's all
so
tools.
We get to choose. We get to choose one of the two, and we click on either the tools or tools. And then if you click accept, you get the tools and money. And then if you choose the food, you get just the food. And these rewards upgrade as we go. And the food obviously will be upgraded. It's not a very rare resource. However, that other resource will be more rare, including furs and stuff, because furs are typically expensive unless you have a very good, outstanding relationship with Tatanka, which is the Iroquois civilization.
So don't be racist.
Yes, don't be racist. Anyway, moving along.
We're coming to the end pretty soon.
Coming to the end here pretty soon. You can see here, that was a sad settler. His house was actually on fire. However, the settlers can also get very angry like that just for you being stupid. If you don't produce the proper goods, you don't make them happy, and you piss them off, well, then they're going to get pissed off, and they can riot and burn down everything. So anyway, this is the end of the second edition of the 1701 AD Build the Ultimate Civilization CD and Game Guides video series. I'm Matt, and I'm here with Joe over here, and we're signing off.
Remember, don't to rape, don't kill, and don't be racist. We love you.
I don't know what don't to rape means, but we're just going to let that one go.